Before the video starts, today's shoutout winner goes to Respawless. If you guys want a chance to win a shoutout in the next video, drop a like and a comment down below, subscribe with notifications on, and I will pick somebody randomly that will be shouted out in my next video. I hope you guys enjoy. Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Tsuki here, and before I spill the tea for you guys, on my last video, a guy named Gumdrop commented saying, "My favorite part of your videos are when you say get some food because it's gonna be juicy, but you didn't say it today." So you know what, guys? Nobody comes to my channel sad, you know? So we actually have a pretty juicy video for today. We have some pretty interesting topics, and before I squeeze out the juice for you guys, I strongly recommend you guys go and get some food to eat. Maybe go and get some burgers, apples, Rice Krispies, some muffins or cupcakes. You know what, guys? If you are really feeling it, maybe quickly run down to 7-Eleven right now and grab some hot dogs and stuff, and then come back to watch this video. And comment down below right now and tell me what you're eating as you're watching this video. I'm always so interested in that kind of stuff, guys. I don't know why. Our first story is absolutely insane, guys. This one's pretty biblical, if I do say so myself. Now, this one's coming from Ghost Issa, a pro player from E11, and a few other people. Now, in summary, Ghost Issa exposed a pro player from E11 Gaming for being racist, and I'm gonna explain this whole story to you guys. So strap in, and let me unleash the juicy stuff to you guys. Now, let's start from the very beginning, and how this story all blew up. Now, it all started when Ghost Issa tweeted out saying, "Turned aim assist off for 3 games. Enjoy the clips. Now, leave me alone with this L2 topic. Thank you." So, you know, it's no big deal. Ghost Issa just posted a few clips on Twitter of him not using aim assist, and he just wanted to show it to all his followers. Literally no big deal, right? But then somebody from Fnatic, who goes by the name Provoked, replied to Issa's tweet by saying, "I don't know why you would post this. Everybody knows aim A is way too broken. It's a effing meme. People have spams L2 in their name, bro. Like, come on." Then Ghost Issa replied with, "I'm posting this because people won't shut up about it whenever I post a normal clip. Obviously you won't understand as a PC player, LMAO, and it's not broken. Don't start this whole argument again." Then Provoked replied with, "Everyone knows it's overpowered. Now stop, it's sad." Then Ghost Issa drops all the balls on Provoked. Issa comes back by saying, "You are sad, LMAO. Arguing about aim assist on Twitter while on vacation. Lol." So you know, Issa has a really good point here. Imagine being on vacation and arguing about aim assist on a video game. Couldn't be me, guys. I could only imagine. Then Vorwin, who is a pro player for FaZe, jumped into the conversation by saying, "Bro, like, come on. It doesn't effing matter if it's overpowered or not. They won't take it out. I'm happy that PS4 has aim assist. Otherwise, normies wouldn't be able to hit a single shot of the joysticks. But please don't say it's not overpowered when there's effing clips that are literally memes." Then Issa replies to FaZe Vorwin by saying, "Holy effing poop. There's no way the both of you are serious. LMAO. I'm not having this argument again. I don't care. Believe what you wanna believe." Then Provoked comes back by saying, "Then why post the effing clip in the first place, moron?" Then Ghost Issa drops the balls once again, guys. Issa replies to Provoked by saying, "To show it's not all effing aim assist, you dumb guy. I don't know why you're being so toxic. Maybe if you had a controller, you would have qualified for the World Cup, I guess. ?" So holy, guys. Issa is now taking shots at Provoked and saying that he didn't qualify for the World Cup. Then Provoked replied with, "Don't pull that. You qualified the week drum gun was broken. Any other week you weren't close." So now Provoked is taking shots at Issa and saying that Issa only qualified for the World Cup during the time the drum gun was broken. Then Issa comes back by saying, "Not close? ?" First week I was 21st, the other week I was something of 30, and 1 week I had pocket loss, so I've been pretty consistent. Unlucky you, weren't good enough without a controller." Then FaZe Vorwin jumps back into the conversation by saying, "He was actually more consistent than you though. Just facts, no beef." Then Ghost Issa drops the balls once again. I have lost count of how many times Ghost Issa has dropped the balls. He replied to Vorwin by saying, "Why are you getting involved, Vorwin? You're the one-time wonder who qualified last week. Holy F, get off my stuff, LMAO." Then Vorwin replied with, "Yeah, luckily I said no beef. Seems like you can't read with your joysticks." Then Issa replied with, "You get involved like that and say, no beef, LMAO." Then FaZe Vorwin comes back by saying, "I didn't beef you at all. I just gave my opinion without offending anyone. If you get offended, it may be your problem, lol." Then Issa says, "I'm chilling. I think all of this is funny AF." And trust me, guys, the juicy stuff is almost coming up. Then FaZe Vorwin replied to Issa by saying, "Then I don't know why you would tell me to get off your stuff, or that I'm the one-time wonder qualified, when you only got it once too. It's just a fact. I didn't beef you, but you did to me even though I was respectful. I don't know, man, we are not kids." And now, guys, finally, the juicy stuff we have all been waiting for. E11 Blood X, who is a pro player for E11 Gaming, jumped into the conversation by saying, "So effing sad. What kind of person you've become, Issa? I really think you should stay off of talking to anyone on socials and sort yourself out, buddy. Take some time off and get better." And Ghost Issa drops the balls one last time, guys. Issa replies to E11 Blood X by saying, "Get off my mentions, you C-word." And Issa also shows a screenshot of E11 Blood X saying, saying the N-word. This is absolutely crazy, guys. And the reason why this is a big deal is because Blood X plays for a very good organization, and he can't be going around dropping the N-word because it does bring down the reputation of his own team, E11, and they can even lose sponsorships because of this, you know. Ghost Issa then tweeted out saying, "Just for clarification, I only posted that picture because it's Blood X. He's one of the fakest people in the community and used to so many people for his own intentions. Most of the pro players will know what I'm talking about. Just watch how he talks to his duos on stream and you will know." Then after that screenshot, Blood X saying the N-word got exposed to the public, a lot of people are pissed off at Blood X. People were sending him hate, and Blood X made a pretty long statement, and in the statement, he goes on to say, "I'm not a racist. Hello. I guess everyone has been waiting for me to speak up after this tweet from Issa and the Fortnite guy for calling me out for being a racist. I wish I was capable of writing at an earlier stage, but it's been a very, very tough past few days. Even now, it's so hard to put words on paper. I have not been able to read all the comments on Twitter because I would legit collapse reading, but I have read some, and I can't say anything else, but it destroys me inside. I still stand by my statement that these accusations of me being a racist and having said that word are not true. I have nothing against colored humans, and I do not treat them any different than other humans, let alone call them names. Ever since childhood, I've spent a lot of time with foreigners. Going to our foreign reception school, I quickly learned in life that we're all the same. We played soccer together, we did schoolwork together. I worked my butt off to help them get allowance from their parents to come visit me and other friends after school. This was not something you could take for granted, having a different culture than ours. Me and my friends wanted them to be the same as us. We wanted them to be able to do everything that we did. We wanted them to be a part of us. How can you call me a racist? Why would I say the N-word? Are you aware that I have soon to be a 2.5-year-old colored son, where his mom and I was together for 7 years, her also being a colored? If you choose to believe that I am a racist, then that is your decision. But that means you are neglecting the actual truth. I've cared and loved foreign humans more than my own family at times. I'm just so speechless. I don't know what to say or write, honestly. That I'm even sitting here having to explain myself why it wasn't me saying those words, and why I'm not a racist, is just beyond everything I stand for. Whatever happens, happens right now. E11 are investigating, and they will probably decide within a short period of time what they want to do with me. Sadly, I think the pressure on me being accused, having said that, and being a racist is just too hard on them. E11 is my family, and I've worked my butt off for them and others the past months, and I'm hoping this ends well. But I expect the worst. If I do end up losing my job due to stuff spread on the internet, I'm not sure what I want to do with that. If I'm going to pursue it to prove my innocence or not, I will talk to one or two lawyers. If people can be held accountable in court of law, then that will happen. This stuff happening to me is just not fair at all. All this over a clipped picture on the internet, who anyone could do, stating that I'm a racist and an abuser of the N-word. And Blood X also shows a picture of his ex-girlfriend, and obviously, Blood X is showing this picture because he wants people to know that he is not a racist, hence why he dated an African-American girl. Blood X then goes on to say, "After having explained the situation for my ex, under no doubt, she gave me the rights of using these two pictures of her, a racist together with a colored girl, right? ? Obnoxious statement to make about me. This text will not be perfect in terms of how it is set up, nor grammar. This is all written under an extremely unhealthy condition. Keep your toxic comments to yourself. I don't need any of that stuff. Other than that, thanks to the people that do support me and have sent me DMs the past couple days. Thanks for keeping my head over the water and knowing the truth, along with knowing who I am. Eric." So you know, Blood X had some pretty good points in this statement. He did say that his ex-girlfriend is a colored human and that he has no problems with any human. And basically, Blood X is saying that Ghost Issa faked that screenshot of him saying the N-word. But also at the same time, I don't think Issa would fake this. Because let's think about it, guys. This all started because of an aim assist argument. I highly doubt Issa photoshopped that picture. Then after Blood X posted that statement, Issa tweeted out saying, "Effing disgusting how he's denying it. Lamau. He didn't only said it once, he said it all the time. Literally the first thing he said when I met him in a call was, 'Gotta be careful at nights on the streets. A N-word could just stab you.' And I wouldn't just post a picture of him saying the word without context. He's been manipulating and using people in the community since the beginning. I don't care what you believe. 90% of the community has experienced it. He's been doing it with me and a lot of kids. If you are gonna be such a disgusting 27-year-old, at least stand up for what you did and don't deny it." Before we move on, I wanna see who made it this far into the video. So if you are hearing this right now, comment down below right now and tell me what team you want to join. I just want to see who's the real one and who actually watches my videos, you know. But now back to the juicy stuff. Also, the team Blood X plays for, which is E11 Gaming, posted a statement on Twitter saying, "Yesterday, there were allegations made against a player on our professional Fortnite roster that were very unsettling and do not align with the values of our organization. We are aware of the severity of the situation and are actively investigating the validity. of the claims presented. Thank you all for your understanding and patience as we work diligently to investigate 11 Gaming. And today, Blood X ended up parting ways with 11 Gaming. He made a short statement on Twitter, and this is what Blood X had to say. Parting ways with 11 Gaming. I am sorry to my fans, friends, for the events that have transpired over the last 3 days. This is simply too much for anyone to take. And because of the comments that were made against me, I have mutually decided to part ways with 11 Gaming. So this no longer negatively affects anyone associated with me. They are my family and a team that believed in me from early on. And for that, I owe them a lot. They just do not deserve this negative attention. I still am in shock that someone would intentionally try to ruin my name and career. From comments that are so far from the values I believe in as a person, I am not a racist and stand by the remarks I made earlier. Anyone close to me will understand that. I will be fighting hard to put respect back into my name. Thank you all for understanding, and I wish 11 Gaming the best in the future. So yeah, guys, you guys heard both sides of the story. Let me know whose side you're on. Are you on Ghost's side, or are you on Blood X's side? Drop it in the comment section down below. And if these allegations of Blood X saying the N-word are true, let me know what you think should happen to Blood X. Should he just quit? Let me know what you think his punishment should be. And if I get more information on the story, I will keep you guys updated. So be sure you are subscribed with notifications on. Our last story is pretty cool, guys. This one's coming from Razor X and Hard Find. Now, I'm sure most of you guys know who they are. Razor X has almost 600k subscribers on YouTube, and Hard Find has almost 200k subscribers. And yesterday, they both ended up leaving BH or Bloodhounds, and then after that, something unexpected happened. I was not expecting this at all, but they both ended up joining Nova, and both their joined Nova tweets got a ton of likes and a ton of retweets, and you know, Nova is getting stacked. They just released their first ever Fortnite team, Touch, and I can just see the future of this team. Nova can easily be at the top. By the end of the year, it's possible that Nova can end up hitting 100k subscribers on YouTube, and I think it's a great thing. Every single day, the Fortnite community just keeps getting bigger and bigger, and this is also a really good thing for me, because then there's gonna be more drama and I can keep making juicy videos for you guys, you know. And speaking of people leaving teams, now I'm not 100% sure if this person left or got kicked from FaZe. And yes, you heard that right, somebody left slash got kicked from FaZe. And if you don't know, it's actually Yellowtree I'm talking about here. He tweeted out saying free agent, and that basically means that he's not in a team anymore. And he didn't really give a statement if he got kicked or if he left, but if I get more information on this, I will keep you guys updated. So be sure to subscribe with notifications on. But that's all the news for today, guys. If you guys happen to enjoy the video, drop a like and a comment. And if you want to be kept updated with everything that happens, make sure to subscribe with notifications on. Okay, peace.